Over in Cebu Province, officials in Lapu-Lapu City have suspended several activities even if the area remains under modified general community quarantine. Group exercises, sporting events, cockfights, beach activities, karaoke, and other non-essential mass gatherings are now prohibited. A liquor ban is also being implemented. The Archdiocese of Cebu is also calling for prayers for its bishops and priests after Cebu Archbishop Jose Palma, Auxiliary Bishop Emeritus Antonio Rañola, and Father Russell Sungkad all tested positive for COVID-19. But the Health Department in Central Visayas says there's nothing to worry about, even though there are two virus mutations in Cebu.
Hindi tayo dapat mabahala talaga kasi 80% or more of these active cases are actually asymptomatic, walang nararamdaman. And then followed by the mild cases. Umaakit yung kaso namin, nag-stabilize kami, triple digit yung numbers namin. Pero yun na nga, dahil meron kaming emergency operation center that is capable of handling, you know, the contact tracing and the isolation of these individuals, hindi po tayo natatakot talaga.
33 villages in Pasay City here in Metro Manila have been placed under a two-week lockdown due to a surge in COVID-19 cases. Pasay City saw a 203% increase in daily new cases compared to 2 weeks ago, the highest in Metro Manila. Local authorities are now strictly monitoring the borders of restricted villages. Only those working and buying essential items are allowed to go out. Now, despite the surge in infections, some residents still want quarantine measures to be relaxed.
Sana nga, maluwagan na kasi marami na rin apektado, di ba? Mag-ingat na lang yung mga mamamayan.
Kung ano man nagpausapan sa NCR, sa LGU, susunod na lang kami.
The Philippines recorded an additional 1,888 new COVID-19 cases on Sunday. Now that brings the total number of infections nationwide to over 561,000. Metro Manila had the most number of new infections at 618, followed by Region 7 or Central Visayas with 404. The Health Department also reported more than 9,000 recoveries, pushing the total to 522,000. Meanwhile, the death toll is at over 12,000 after 20 more people died due to the disease. Vice President Leandro Bredo says the Duterte administration should prioritize vaccinations instead of easing quarantine restrictions at this time. In her weekly radio program, Robredo questioned the decision of some local officials to recommend that the entire country shift to the most relaxed community quarantine level.
Nagkamali tayo mula umpisa pa kasi hinihiwalay natin yung ekonomi sa kalusugan. Sa akin, yung mga usapin ng ganito, dapat sana lahat ng energies natin nandun sa pag-control ng transmission saka pag-provide ng bakuna, hindi na sa kung ano-ano pa. Dapat isentro na lahat dun kasi yun yung pinakamahalaga ngayon.